Hello dear students, today I am going to explain two numerical problems which are based on a microbiological technique, that is standard plate count agar method. All of you know that this technique is used to count or to enumerate microorganisms present in the given sample. So there are two numericals I am going to explain here. So let's see, first one, 36 colonies grew in nutrient agar from 1 ml of sample withdrawn from a solution of 10 ml which is diluted to 10 raised to the power minus 5 in a standard plate count procedure. How many cells were in the original sample? So this is the numerical problem here. There are 36 colonies are formed on nutrient agar from the 1 ml sample and which is taken from the 10 ml of diluted solution, and the dilution used is 10 raised to the power minus 5. Now here we have to calculate the total number of cells present in the original sample. So here these are the options here, but we will see how such calculations can be done, because these are useful to your NET exams or SET exams, or if you are preparing for MSc entrance exams. See the solution here. Now this information, it is given, that is 36 colonies, then 1 ml sample, it is taken from 10 ml, that is original sample, and the dilution used is 10 raised to the power minus 5. So this we have to calculate, how many cells were in the original sample. So the formula which is used for calculations in such numericals is this one. Number of colony forming units formed divided by volume of sample used for the plating, for example here, equal to number of colony forming units per ml. So here, see the total number of colonies formed, these are 36 colony forming units, and the volume used, it is 1 ml. So it will become 36 colony forming units divided by 1 ml. It is equal to 36 colony forming units per ml. And the dilution which is used is 10 raised to the power minus 5. So here, 36 colony forming units per ml, this formula we are putting here, this answer. So 36 colony forming units per ml divided by dilution used, and the dilution used is 10 raised to the power minus 5. So it will become 36 into 10 raised to the power 5. So because this denominator, when it comes to numerator, so it will become positive or plus, so that will become 10 raised to the power 5. So therefore 36 colony forming units per ml divided by 10 raised to the power minus 5 equal to 36 into 10 raised to the power 5. So later on, see, this is the further solution of this mathematical expression here. 36 we have written as it is into 10 raised to the power 5 means multiplied by 10 into 10 into 10 into 10 into 10. So that will become 36 into 1 lakh. So it will become, that is 36 lakh colony forming units per ml. So here the answer will become total number of colonies, that is 36 lakh colony forming units, or that colonies, and these are present in 1 ml of that sample. Now we have to calculate the total number of cells in the original sample, and we are having that 10 ml of solution. So that's why total number of cells in the original sample, it is equal to, because in 1 ml 36 lakh cells are present. So that's why it will become 36 lakh into 10, because we are having 10 ml of that sample. So that's why 36 lakh into 10, and it will become 3 crore 60 lakh. So this will be the final answer, and whatever these 3 crore 60 lakh colony forming units are present, these are present in our original sample, that is in 10 ml. Or we can write in this way also, 3.6 into 10 raised to the power 7. So therefore the answer is here, or the correct option is E. So whatever that five options are given here, and in this case the correct option is 5. So this is the one problem here. Second problem, it is of same type. See, 36 colonies grew in a nutrient agar from 0.1 ml of sample withdrawn from a solution which is diluted to 10 raised to the power minus 3 in a standard plate count procedure. How many cells were in the original sample? This example is also same as like that of first problem, just there are numbers are changed here. Total number of colonies are same as like in first problem, but the sample taken is here 0.1 ml and the total volume is 1 ml and the dilution used is 10 raised to the power minus 3. So we'll see again by the same method. See, this information is given to us, that is 36 colonies, then 0.1 ml of sample, and it is taken from 1 ml and the dilution used is 10 raised to the power minus 3. So again we have to calculate how many cells were in the original sample, that is in 1 ml of that sample. So again same formula, number of colony forming units formed divided by volume of sample taken is equal to number of colony forming units per ml. So total number of colony forming units formed, these are 36, so that's why we have written here 36 colony forming units divided by volume of sample taken, it is 0.1. So and finally it is dilution used 10 raised to the power minus 3, so that's why it will become 360 colony forming units per ml. So again same here, dilution used is 10 raised to the power minus 3, so that's why I have written here 360 colony forming units per ml divided by 10 raised to the power minus 3. So 360 multiplied by 10 raised to the power 3, because that 10 raised to the power minus 3, it will become 10 raised to the power plus 3. So we can convert here 3.6 into 10 raised to the power 5. So again further solution of this is 3.6 into 10 raised to the power 5 means multiplied by 10, multiplied by 10, multiplied by 10, multiplied by 10 and multiplied by 10, and finally the answer will become, that is 360,000 colony forming per ml. So the number of colonies or colony forming units in 1 ml of sample, it is equal to 360,000 colony forming units per ml. So therefore the total number of cells in the original sample was 1 ml, and so that's why the answer is 360,000 and the correct option is C. So these are the simple problems here. So just I have taken two examples here. You can solve many such type of examples by yourself. Thank you.